weights on 7 pounds, the black shorts, he's from South Shields, Sam Hockey Jockey Bendon.
Okay lads, keep your heads up, keep your punches up, keep it clean. BMI commands are all times, protect yourself at all times. Touch gloves, come on, boxing on the bell, let's go. The man on the bell is James Hall.
Okay, here we are with the first fight of the evening here. Phil Lindsay here with Jordan Ellison with co-commentary. And the first fight, we've got Sam Menzies from South Shields against Stephen Maguire from Manchester. It's Menzies' fourth fight. He's won the first three fights. He had two fights back in 2018 and he... But I feel it was last month. So he's looking to get going again.
It's a good little fight. This both lads are wiry. Both just looking to measure each other out tonight so far. No one wanting to commit too early.
Yeah, you can see Maguire. He's on the back foot. He's looking at the counter.
Good body shot there.
Go it, Steve, hands up. That's the backhand, there you go, hands up.
Good display of boxing so far, both working behind the jabs. No one wanting to commit too far.
Yeah, you can see Menzies trying to get the pressure on. He's looking to dominate. You'd expect that being the home fighter.
But Maguire
can certainly box.
Yeah, he just needs to be a little bit cautious. He doesn't walk onto something too dramatic.
Elbows in, watch the body shot. Hands up, body
shot. He is working with the body well there, Menzies, so far.
Yeah, hands up, kid. Elbows in, that's it. That's the way, movement as well. Yeah, movement, Steve. Movement. That's good dunking, there you go. You got tight, Steve. That's it, slide away. Slide away from the shot. Slide away. A little slide away, you want? Come back with your backhand. Backhand, Steve. Tight guard. Keep your gloves.
Nice first round.
I think the body work from Menzies is the difference in this round so far.
Oh, 100%. There we go. He's just walked on something too. And again, two ice. That's what I was talking about earlier on. Just telling him. He needs to be a bit cautious walking in.
One, two, Steve.
You can see Maguire's actually waiting for that.
He is. He's looking for that backhand. Menzies is just walking in too much. Sometimes he needs to be a bit cautious, work behind the jab, feint, and then go.
Backhand.
His head's a bit high coming out.
So backhand, one, two, it's working.
It's only the first round, though. People still warming into it.
One, two. Yard up.
That's the thing when you get these four rounders, though. There's not much room for error if you have a slow start.
No, it's not. It's not. So, yeah, some people do try and force it, like to start fast, but that's when you're more likely to walk onto something dangerous.
Yeah, of course.
Still, even though it's a four-round, you still need to just
hands
like
up, Steve,
that.
Hands up.
Just work your way in. Don't lunge in.
Hands up, Steve. Come on, hands up. One, two. Yeah, jab out, Steve. You're not jabbing enough. Keep him away from the backhand you want. You're hurting with backhand. Backhand.
There's the 10-second clapper. Almost the end of the first round here. And time. So, first round of the evening. How do you score that one, Jordan?
Menzies just for the pressure. He's coming forward. He is trying a bit too hard sometimes. And like you're saying, he's walking onto the backhand, the southpaw backhand. But both men, what I've noticed, they're starting to neglect the jab close to the end of that round. Yes, it's southpaw versus orthodox. But the key to every fight, every opponent, is a jab. If you don't do that jab, you're not finding your range, and you're more likely to walk onto the back end of the opponent or a sharp left hook.
Yeah, it's not even just the jabs that land, it's actually getting yourself into range as well, isn't it? It's
100%.
Maneuvering yourself.
Yeah. I think Sam just needs to stop lunging in a little bit much. Yes, keep the pressure there. Well, just flick that jab out, then work the body head like he's been doing. But he's just been neglecting the jab a little bit too much.
Yeah, maybe a little bit more variety in there as well.
Yeah. From both fighters.
Seconds out, round two.
Thing is, though, you can understand, obviously, you've been in there, obviously, from Menzies' sort of perspective. He's got people local here. He's the one expected to put the show on.
Oh, 100%. It is a different game when you're the home fighter and your crowd's here and you want to impress. But at the same time, you're there to win.
Yeah.
Like, if you go home and lose, your crowd's not going to be there to support you. You need to look for yourself and yourself only. Yes, try and put a show on, but do the job, look after yourself and fight smart. Don't try and impress too much and walk up to something stupid.
He started this round much better, man.
Yes.
He's actually become the counter puncher on this round.
He has. It's working out better for him.
Yeah. Well. He's landed some quality right hands there.
Now he's working the job there.
Good block.
Good movement from Menzies there. Good little movement.
That's good one,
too. Yep. Certainly come in here with ambition. He's in there to fight, that's for sure.
Oh, he is.
But you don't always see, obviously, whenever you go on the road, you're known for always having a go.
Oh, yeah.
But not everybody does that.
No, some men just go in there and survive. And that's not the case tonight. The case tonight is that both men are having a go of each other. It just so happens that Menzies just get that little bit ahead. But both men are giving good effort, good performance.
1-2, 1-2. Let's go. There you go, 1-2 again. Come on, and again. 1-2 again. Throw it, man. Throw the body shot, Mel. Throw the shot. There you go, Sam.
There we go, the jab's finding the range.
Guard up, Steve. 1-2.
Those body shots from Menzies are working really well. But he has had more variety this round.
He is, yes. But
come on, keep going.
But like I say, the end of the first round, he's just neglecting the jab again. Near the end of the rounds, as both men started to neglect the jab a bit too much, and just look for the shot, like the power shot.
Which again, you get the instructions in the corner, and then you're out there for the first couple of minutes, and then you go back to the instinct, don't you?
Yeah, you go to your instincts. Oh, it's good backhand.
Good right hand from Menzies.
It's a really good display of boxing from Menzies tonight.
He has. He's really stepped it up. He's.
I was at his last fight, and tonight's performance is twice the performance as it was in his last fight.
Yeah, I think he'd had about 2 or 3 year gap before his previous two fights, hadn't he?
Oh yes. Like in his last fight, he didn't do bad. He done really well. Obviously, he got the win. But like you say, he's having that much time out. He will be a bit cautious, a bit nervous, rusty. Now he's knocked all that off. He's coming in tonight, and I'm very impressed with his display of boxing so far.
Yeah. I'd give him the first two rounds. First round was fairly close.
Yeah.
Second round was definitive. But it was the way he boxed totally differently there. Exactly what you were asking for.
He went from the aggressor, trying to force too much, to then being the smarter counterpuncher. Letting his opponent just walk onto the shot. Beginning of the round, yes, he done like I say, he worked the jab, started moving behind the jab. But then, like you say, as the round go on, your instincts come into play and you try and throw a bit more power punches. But I can't fault him so far. His movement's great, his boxing's great, his variety's great. It's just an all-round great performance so far.
I think first round he started getting caught on the way in.
Yeah.
But he looked to have corrected that there now. Let's see how the third round goes here. Just in case there any doubts, Menzies is the boxer in the black shorts. Maguire in the blue with the red and white trim.
Where's your left hand to the body, straight left.
No, 1-2. Like, we've got to give Maguire some credit as well. Maguire's not coming here just to lie down and...
He's having a right go.
And just get through the round. Maguire's having a good go. He's trying to get this win. It's just Menzies' display of boxing. It's amazing working the head and body.
Well, for the most part, Maguire's actually had a losing record on the road. But it was he had his first win a couple of fights back.
Yeah.
And you can see he's got plenty of ambition.
Yeah, he's using with confidence, and it's a good fight. But you can't just look at people's records. Myself, people would look at my record and think, oh, he's lost more than he's won. Now look what I've done over my last two and won the Northern Area title. And now I'm going on for bigger things. So I would never ever underestimate someone's record.
You've got to call some shots, Steve. 1-2. 1-2, body shot there now.
It's just Maguire's in against a smarter, better Menzies tonight.
Body. There you go, one against Steve.
Good body shot there from Menzies.
Very good.
And again.
Looked a bit low, that one, but blind side of the referee. That's the time to do it. It's great boxing, great footwork there.
I love how Menzies is pivoting off to his left-hand side, away from the southpaw backhand.
Big 1-2, Steve. Straight 1-2.
He's not discouraging Maguire, though.
No. I just think Maguire's getting a bit too frustrated sometimes.
There you go. And a body shot. And a body
I think
shot,
he's just getting
shot.
Frustrated from Menzies' movements.
Yeah. That's superb, that. Absolutely superb.
Oh, and again, 1-2. 1-2, Steve. Come on. Well, 1-2 left hook as well. 1-2 out. Come on, hands up.
Considering both men were late replacements into this show, both men are putting on an amazing display.
Hands up now,
especially Menzies.
That's the low shot.
Be interesting to see the fitness levels going into the last round as well.
Oh, yes. But like you say, we both know Menzies boxed last month. So if he's been a true professional, he'll have been back in the gym anyways. Yeah.
I'm just
amazed by the difference from last month to this month of Menzies' performance. He just looks like a complete different fighter. Oh, he got caught with a backhand there. Yeah. He's been hurt there.
Sam against Steve, 1-2.
I think he needs to get. I think Sam needs to
get the body there.
He needs to get his chin down, work away on his jab, get around to the left, away from the southpaw backhand.
10 seconds, come on, Steve. Work. Keep working. He's tired now. Put it on him, Steve.
That was good work, varying the power on the shots there.
Very good round. I still give it to Menzies, but Maguire did have some flashes of success there, especially catching Menzies with that left hand.
Yeah,
it was an amazing shot.
So if you're Mal Gates in the Menzies corner, what are you saying for the final round here?
I'd say the first, especially the first minute of the round, obviously I know you can't tell, you can't see the time in there, but I'll definitely say the first half of the round, get behind the jab, because if that backhand has hurt Menzies, he's still going to be a bit cautious in his mind.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to think, right, he's hurt me, I'm going to try and hurt him now, because then he's going to walk onto something stupid, maybe it's that backhand again. So what I would tell him, I would say, get out there, chin down, don't tighten up, nice and loose, work behind the jab, move to your left. Wait, first half of the round, just keep out the way, keep behind the jab, dictate the round still, don't let him just walk forward and bully you, dictate the round behind the jab, gather yourself, and then step it up at the back end of the round.
So you don't want to be going into the second half of the round, tiring, flagging.
One, two, Steve, come on.
Like we say, Maguire's not here just to sit down, so...
Far from.
So, if Menzies tries to come out and catch Maguire because Maguire caught him with a good shot in the last round, it'll probably be not the smartest of tactics.
1-2, 1-2.
Again, Maguire's looking like he's going for the counter again, yeah?
Step in.
And that's probably his best chance at this stage.
Hands up.
Landed with a big shot on the way in.
Good body shot again there from Menzies.
Yeah, those rights to the body have been on point all night.
Yeah, 1-2, see, keep from 1-2, it's working. And again, 1-2 again, come on. Get right hook onto it. 1-2 right hook. See,
once again, like I say, but obviously I know they're tired, but it's last round of fighting, both men are just completely neglecting the jab.
Yeah.
I think both men are just looking to dominate too much. I know in later rounds of the fight, the boxing kind of does go out the window, but that's where you look the best. When you're behind your boxing and your opponent's tired, you make them make more mistakes.
But it's just basic fundamentals as well, though.
It is.
Go, go, go. Well, combination, Steve.
But at the same point, he's still boxing very well, yeah.
Oh, both men are still boxing well.
Left-hand body, Steve.
I love Menzies' little pivots off there.
I know.
To the left-hand side, and then he's just... Soon as he's around, he doesn't just run away. He gets around and then jumps back in with a counter.
There you go. And again, 1-2, 1-2.
Yeah, he looks like he's balanced on point all the time as well.
Yes, good backhand there on the inside. Sharp backhand from Menzies.
Keep your guard up, Steve. Keep your guard up. Keep your guard up, Steve. 1-2, 1-2.
I wouldn't mind this going another couple of rounds here.
go,
good
jab,
fight.
Jab, hands up, hands
oh, it's a very good fight. I just think both men need to work the jab, find the range, instead of lunging in.
Guard up, Steve, come on. 1-2, 1-2, Steve. Throw it, throw it, throw it. Good combination.
Good uppercut hook there from Menzies, really good.
Working, working. Working, Steve, working. 1-2. Combination, Steve, come on. Yeah. What's his head there? What's his head there? What's his head? Hands up, Steve. What's your left hook now, Steve?
You can see both men are tired. They're coming out and their chins are high. That's what I was saying like before. If you stick to your boxing, stick to your boxing and keep behind that jab early rounds, in the later part of the round when your opponent's tired and he's making mistakes like that, his chin's high, you've got more chance of landing the bigger, stronger shots to get a knockdown or a knockout. Very good fight.
Quality fight. How did you score that one in the end?
40-36 for Menzies. Yeah, like I say, Maguire showed some flashes of like potential in some of the rounds, getting Menzies with some good shots, but there just wasn't enough consistency there throughout the round. He just took his foot off the gas a little bit too much, and Menzies just dominated it from there on after. The first round was the closest round between it all. Third round, Menzies got caught with that backhand, got a little bit of pressure put on him.
Yeah.
But that's probably the most promising performance from Maguire.
The first round was fairly close as well, terms of how much happened. But there's Paul Charters as well. He's going to be in with John T.K. Valeu later on.
Yeah.
Should be an interesting fight.
I'm really looking forward to that fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, can both these fighters round of applause, please?
Here we have Billy Hardy with the scores.
How do you?
After 4 rounds of boxing, your referee has judged your winner. With a point score of 40-36, your winner in the blue corner, Sam Mendes, the Pocket Rockets.
Well, you called it, John. 40-36.
Yeah. That's perfect. It's exactly what I thought it would be.